Hey guys, welcome back to a Friday night edition of Our Daily Word at the River. I'm coming to you guys through this video versus live because as I am probably uploading this, I'm actually driving. I'm going for a birthday celebration with my family this week. So I hope you guys are doing well and I would appreciate your prayers as we're traveling. But I did want to go ahead and hopefully I will be able to upload this. So if you're seeing that, you know I was successful. Otherwise, nobody will know the difference, right? So, anyway, I hope you guys are doing well. I hope you're having a good week. Tonight, we're going to continue on with our 12 Disciples series. This is our second week for Simon Peter. And we're going to talk about how Jesus called him and his leadership ability. So, we've all had leaders. Most of us have probably had good leaders. We've had great leaders. We've had some leaders that were just okay. And some of us have probably not had such good leaders. You know, we would probably classify them as bad leaders. But no matter what you've had, we understand leadership. Even if you're not a leader, we've all been in that position where we have to follow leadership. So we want to talk about that a little bit. What does God say about that? What did Christ say about that? What does it look like when you are called to be a leader? We all have gifts, and leadership is one of those God-given gifts. And if we use it correctly and in His ways, I think we can become great leaders. But we see here that Simon was called to be a leader, but he wasn't always a great leader. He had to learn to lead. And so we're going to talk about that a little bit because I think that pertains to all of our gifts. Even if your gift is not leadership, maybe it's teaching, maybe it's the gift of mercy, maybe it's a gift of giving, you know, your gift giver. We have to understand that what we can learn from Simon Peter is that God develops us through our relationships with other people, through circumstance, through experience. And if we allow God to use those things to develop us, we will become what He's called us to be. But just like with Simon, we have to work towards that. I think a lot of us, I think maybe earlier in my spiritual journey, I just thought, well, if God says I'm a leader or I'm a teacher, then I will just be naturally good at it. And quite honestly, but to some degree, that's true. There are some natural gifts, but it's just like an athlete. An athlete can have all the gifts in the world, but that's only going to carry them so far. They have to work at what they want to achieve. I've known a lot of good athletes, and some of them have great work ethics, and some of them don't. And usually that ability to work, that ability to train, that ability to reach past their current state of where they are, that's what makes them great. That takes them from good to great, and that's the difference. That's the difference a lot of times in somebody who's extremely successful and somebody that's just mediocre. It's just their ability to work and to train. It's not their God-given talent. It's their ability to put some work into it behind what those talents are. So we're going to talk about that. I want to read a couple of quotes to you guys and to talk about what leadership is. Napoleon Bonaparte said, "A leader is a dealer in hope." Robert Jarvie, the creator of the artificial heart, said, "Leaders are visionaries with a poorly developed sense of fear and no concept of the odds against them." Tom Landry, who's a coach, said, "Leadership is getting someone to do what they don't want to do to achieve what they want to achieve." And John Maxwell says, "All leadership is influence." President Dwight Eisenhower stated, "Leadership is the art of getting someone else to do something you want done because he wants to do it." So you guys, those are all different quotes on leadership that we have to think about. How do you line up? Who are you? I think out of those two, the one that Tom Landry said, "Leadership is getting someone to do what they don't want to do to achieve what they do want to achieve," is probably something that I can relate to the most. I've had people in my life that encourage me to do hard things, to encourage me to do things that are not necessarily easy, but are necessary for me to accomplish my big goal, what I want out of life. So we're going to talk about that with Simon Peter. We know that Simon Peter was the leader of the 12, and he is quoted often and is central to many of the stories that we have. And so we're going to talk about that. We know that Christ had put him in that position. He had some natural ability, but we also know that Simon Peter was a man who was very quick to speak his mind and very reactionary and very, for lack of a better word, he had no restraint. And so we're going to talk about that. We know that leaders are people of great potential. We've talked about that already a little bit, that you can have great potential, but what do you do with that? How many of y'all have ever heard somebody say, well, they have great potential, but they just never lived up to it? Or they have all the talent in the world, but they won't do their work. You guys, a great leader will do that extra step. And so we see here that when Jesus met Peter, he saw that he had great potential. The word Simon means listener. Well, we know that's contradictory to what he was when Christ met him. But not only that, he gave him he called him Simon, and then he used a word called Cephas, which means Peter. Peter means the rock. And so even though when Christ met Peter, he was not a good listener and he wasn't very steadfast, he wasn't very stable, Christ called him as though he was. He named him according to the potential he saw. Well, you guys, there's other scripture that says that he calls things as though they were. That is what our faith is. We believe in things as though they were, not as though we see them. That's faith. And we see Jesus actively showing us and demonstrating that to us through him calling Simon Peter, right? The second thing that we know is that leaders are known for being a people of courage. So as we read before, they don't understand fear. Or when they do understand fear, let's talk about that because we all have fear. I've often heard the quote that faith is acting through your fear, right? Not being courage is going through your fear, right? And there's a quote, and I'm not able to really remember it right now, but it's moving through it. It's not that you don't have fear, it's that you continue to move through that. You guys, I've done a lot of things in my life that I was truly afraid of and that I was fearful, but I continue to move past that, right? I continue to work through that. I didn't let that fear stop me. And that's the difference between a good leader and a great leader. They will move past all the obstacles. They will move through all of the what ifs and all the things that seem that you can't overcome, they will continue through that. And we saw that with Peter. We see that as we read in Matthew 14, 28 through 33, they were on the water and all the disciples were there. And I'm going to read it. It said, basically Jesus was on the water and they thought it was a ghost. And Peter replied, Lord, if it's you, tell me to come to you on the water. Come, he said, and then Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and beginning to sink, cried out, Lord, save me. Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. You have little faith, he said, why did you doubt? And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Now, on first glance, we hear that Jesus rebukes him because he doesn't have faith. But if you guys read that, if you've ever been in a boat, it takes courage for him to just jump out of that boat. What made him think that he wasn't going to sink? You can't tell me that the wind and the waves were not there. I think he did have tremendous courage. Courage and faith are different, right? Faith is what continues when you do see all those obstacles coming at you. A lot of us, we know that Peter was a little bit, he jumped before he thought. He was impulsive, if you will. He may have been the current ADHD kid, I'm not sure, but he was impulsive. And so we know that he jumped out of the boat. That takes an immense amount of courage, but what he didn't have was the faith to continue even when the winds and the waves kept coming. You guys, I've been there. How many of us get in the middle of a trial and it gets hard and it's a lot harder than you thought it would be, or it takes longer than you thought it would be? You guys, I'm telling you, that's a gut check moment. And I've had those recently. I've had those gut check moments. I'm going to have them again. I'm going to have to continue to check myself because as you walk in faith, it's not just about starting the journey, it is about completing the entire thing. And that's what Jesus was really getting on to him about, is you got to finish it. You have to finish it. He was training him right then to be a great leader. He was teaching him that because Jesus knew that there was more to Peter's life than that moment on the water. He knew that he was training him for days down the road when he was going to hit that rough patch again. No, it wasn't going to be a physical on the water with the wind and the waves. It was literally going to be persecution from outside. He was training Peter at that moment and teaching him, do not give up. You guys, that I'm telling you, as I teach that, as I tell you that, it just like literally punches me in the chest. Do not give up. Life is going to be hard. If you're in recovery, if you're going through any kind of stress, if you're dealing with COVID, you guys, we're all getting tired. We are all thinking, God, when is this going to end? And we don't know. It doesn't seem to be ending. It seems to just continue on. And I understand. I have opinions, but I don't feel the need to express them. But I think we can all identify, no matter where you are, I'm ready for this to be over. You guys, that was small in comparison to other things. If you know, illnesses that we fight, relationship issues that we fight, stress that just will not give up, financial stress, business stress. You guys, we all get there. If you're a follower of Christ, you're not excused from that. Neither was Peter. And that's when he talks about have faith, continue on. And so the last thing we want to talk about, our leaders are people of action. And so we see that Christ called Peter and named him as though what he was going to be, not what he was, but what he was going to be. And then he encouraged that courage in him, but not only that, to continue with the faith, have faith when things get hard. And the last thing that we see is that Peter was a man of action. He was quick to react. But in a lot of ways, that's what was needed. So there was two times I want to bring out to you guys, is Peter was actually one of the ones that ran back. Peter and John ran back to the tomb. John actually got to the tomb first. So, the rock was rolled away. It was empty. John stood outside. Peter ran in. He wasn't afraid of what he was going to find. He was interested. He wanted to know. Now, I'll be honest with you, I'd probably be a little bit like John. I'd be scared or maybe fearful of what I was going to see. Maybe, who knows why he didn't go. And it may not that he was scared. Maybe he didn't want to see his Lord and Savior in there and in the way it is. Who knows? But he didn't go in, but Peter did. Peter wanted to know. And the second time that we see Peter stand up is on the day of Pentecost, and they needed a leader because they were getting persecuted. They were being called drunkards, and oh my goodness, what's wrong with these people? And it was Peter that stood up and gave direction to the crowd of 3,000. And it was Peter who gave that message, and the 3,000 came. Now, you guys, we're going to talk about next week. There was a lot that happened between the tomb and that day. But yet Peter came back and did what he was called to do. He did. And so I want to encourage you guys with that. Peter was a leader in the making. He was not a leader from the get-go. He had to learn to lead with greatness. And I think he did. He was not perfect, as none of them were, and neither are we. But he still had the gift and the calling that God continued to perfect in him, even though he was human and man, and he did things that we all do. You guys, Peter felt the same way that we all do when we mess up. How can we do that? We loved our God so much. How can we mess up? But we do. But God continues to create in us those things that we need to become what he's called us for. So I hope you guys are having a great week. I will see you guys next week. But just a reminder, we do have Sunday school 9 o'clock on Sunday. We will start a small group on 5 with both men and women. And then we'll have our Sunday night service. And then the week will start again. So I hope you guys are doing well. And have a great weekend. Talk to you soon. Bye.